What's up, you guys? It's PDX. If you've been seeing the channel for the past few weeks, maybe months, you'll know that I met up with Nii, I met up with Arsalan, I met up with Book. They were in the US, and I keep referring to the story I'm going to tell and then never actually tell it all the way. So basically, I have a clip from the stream that day where I told the whole story. However, it is a really, really long and rambly story. It covers my trip to get there, all the drama day one when I had no internet, day one, all the drama... how I got there, everything before, the drama day one, and then this takes place during the actual stream on day two of my trip there. So because it's such a long story, I'd rather post the stream clip than play it again. But I know you guys like to get bored and things like that. So I'm going to put up some of the gameplay of me versus Nii and Arsalan from those days, okay? Again, they are available on my VODs channel, but I figured this story needs to be told. Some people want to hear it, and we'll quell the short attention spans with some Tekken gameplay. It's good gameplay. There's just no commentary over it. You'll get the story of how I ever even got there in the first place. So brief overview of how it even came to be in the first place. I heard from my friend Tone that there was going to be some like secret invitee event happening in California. We thought it was in NorCal, and they were inviting the 7 former Evo champions, like Lohi, JDCR, Nobi, Saint, Nii, Arsalan, and Book. The 7 former Evo champions of Tekken 7 going to California to play an early build of Tekken 8. Evo would broadcast it, and it was more of an exhibition than a tournament. So if you saw the event and the analysis, I did. But basically, the way I saw it was, okay, let's go and play this tournament. Like, I thought it was going to be a Tekken 7 tournament. We found out later there's no Tekken 7 tournament. Okay, well, at least maybe we can go watch and meet the pros and hang out. No, it's a private event. You can't come in. So a weekend before the actual trip, I was debating cancel my flight because I thought, well, what's the point of me even going out? And then, of course, as I was resting for the couple downtime days I had, I thought, when is another time that all these world-class players are going to be in one place in the United States? And not only are they in the United States, but they aren't even preparing for a tournament. If they were preparing for a very serious event, I wouldn't have done this, okay? But because I knew it was a casual event, I felt really comfortable kind of trying to, you know, snipe their off days. Like, yes, of course, I could book a trip to Pakistan, Korea, Japan, Thailand, all separate trips or one long one, get all the visas sorted out, pay a bunch of money for lodging and logistics, or I could fly to LA and meet up with them there. And the bonus is that my rationale is, outside of the event day and the media day before where they do interviews and things like that, they would probably be bored. Like, they give them extra days to like acclimate and deal with the jet lag and things like that. But if there's no event, no training, no, they don't have all their training partners and stuff, what are they going to do? They don't have tour guides. Maybe we could hang out and just play some Tekken. So that was my gamble, was if I flew out there, I found out what hotel they were at, and bring my stream PC, bring my microphones, bring my mixers, bring everything, and pray that it ends up working out. Maybe we could play some games. Maybe I could get some coaching. You know, it was a crapshoot. It was a total long shot. And at no point during the whole trip did I ever feel like, yeah, this was a great idea. In fact, almost every point of the trip, as the story in the stream clip will tell, I thought, oh my God, I just burnt all this money for no reason. Nobody's going to show up. The internet isn't working. My PC is failing. Every single issue that you could think of came up. So ultimately, I'm so glad it worked out. It was a long 4-day weekend. I probably slept maybe like 10 to 16 hours that whole weekend just trying to deal with everything. But I'm really grateful I did. I'm grateful that you guys have been giving me a lot of support when I put the videos up and did the analyses and all of those things. And I hope you enjoy the actual story happening in the stream clip where I talk about every single thing going wrong that could have gone wrong. So yeah, this stream clip occurs on day two. Day one, I actually played the games with Arsalan. That's where the footage comes from, and I had no chance to stream it, so it was a perfect time to publish it here. Day two, I am waiting for everybody to arrive for the second day, and because nobody shows up for like an hour, I just start rambling about the story. That's the context of the stream clip. Appreciate you guys. Enjoy the video.
Okay. So, let me explain this whole thing of how it came together. I got home from... So I was on vacation with the family, with my girlfriend's family, from last Saturday till this past Saturday. So 2 Saturdays ago till this last Saturday. We flew out Saturday morning and we went to San Diego for Run It Black's wedding. So we spent Saturday, Sunday, went back home Monday. I had the flight here because initially when I was planning, I was talking to Tony and he said it would be a tournament like that we could enter. So I wanted to enter the tournament, but the more details came, it turns out it was going to be in SoCal instead of NorCal. It turned out it was going to be just the pros playing. It was a Tekken 8 event. I was so confused. I was like, okay, well, should I just cancel my flight? What's the point? Oh, this is an important part of the story. So I had to mention this. The week-long vacation, it was an all-inclusive resort, which is basically you pay everything up front, and then everything you eat and drink there is free, basically. You don't pay any extra. So that's cool, and it's whack. When I was a kid, that shit was really, really cool. Because as a kid, everything has to go through the parents, right? So when you buy some, when you get food for free, it's kind of like sick, you know? That's awesome. As an adult, I'm used to like paying for shit. So I was kind of excited to be like, yo, like I don't gotta pay for anything. Like I could just go and eat. But the problem is once you're an adult, you start caring about other things. Like I'm getting a little fucking fat, like eating so goddamn much. The food isn't even that good, right? So like, it's like, it wasn't as fun because I'm just getting fat off of mid food. You know what I mean? And then we're drinking all the time. So, and we didn't have like any other, like I couldn't bring like edibles or gummies or anything to Mexico. I didn't want to be like imprisoned, you know? So I was just like fat, hungover and queasy like the whole time. And then it's like my girlfriend's family, right? So I want to make like a good impression. So I have to be social while being fat, hungover and queasy. So yeah, the drinks will cost you a lot. So as an adult going there, it's like, oh yeah, drink up, bro. Like you got to get in there, you know? So that shit was crazy. And it was a good trip. And obviously I'm grateful to go. But in terms of like nightly cost, I pay more at like tournament hotels. So Wednesday night, so I grind a bunch of work Tuesday and Wednesday. Wednesday night, I start packing all my shit. Portable monitor, both my microphones, audio interface, Go XLR, all this shit. I brought like a shitty keyboard because I didn't want to stress about it. But this was insane. This was just such an insane trip. So let me pull up now the setup I was packing. Okay, so also when I travel with this PC, what happens is this red fan, every time I like, because the, you know, like the PC gets bumped around in like TSA and shit like that. So it would get bumped. Oh, you can't see them. Basically, with this red fan, every time I travel with it, it like rattles. It like starts to rattle. And the only way I can get it to stop is by flicking it. There's no other way to describe it. I have to flick the fan until I got it to like realign. Shit is so goofy. So I brought another fan because I had a feeling on this trip everything would go wrong. So I brought another PC fan just in case. And of course, I flicked this thing for like an hour pause and I couldn't get it to realign. So I reinstalled the other one. That was the first of many disasters that these couple days have really brought up. How did I pack a PC? So I carried on the PC. I carried on the PC and then I carried on the PC and I checked in everything else. But the PC I insisted on carrying on, and then my backpack had my arcade stick. I literally just, this is a pretty small case, so I just put it in like a roller bag that I could carry on. Anyway, it's not important, okay? PC, we're not here to nerd about PCs. My point was I had to do repairs on the fly, okay? That was the first of many troubles. But just so you get the idea of the scale of this operation, so this was the first setup, right? I got, So I didn't, I also shipped things from Amazon to the hotel, okay? Because I obviously couldn't take everything. So the first thing that happened was I get to the hotel at like 7 in the morning and they say like they're fully booked, they won't have a room ready, and checkout's at noon. I'm like, okay, that's kind of fine, I still gotta work. So I pull up my laptop, sit down in the lobby with my laptop. And remember, this is full shipped? No, nothing shipped. Oh, from Amazon, yeah. But I bought like 2 shipped. So I'm fully, yes, the pre-show, I'm explaining the whole the journey here. The hotel said that they accepted packages. So I shipped everything to the hotel, or I like bought it on Amazon and shipped it to the hotel. I'm there at 7 in the morning. I have horrible coffee come down in 3 bags, right? And I gotta work. I gotta code. You know how I feel about coding. So I actually was really productive, which was surprising. And they said they would call me when the room was ready. So this was like 7 in the morning, right? Oh, and the dude who was supposed to pick me up from the airport didn't wake up. So I had to Uber from the airport to the Burbank hotel. Okay, Jesus. Let's see. He didn't wake up. We Uber. I'm there early. They won't give me a room because they're full. It makes sense. Working from like 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. And I see a bunch of people go to the desk and just get rooms. So at like 1 p.m., I was just like, everybody's getting rooms. What's going on? They said like checkout's at noon and it takes 2 to 3 hours to clean a room. So you didn't tell me? Yeah, that is my fault. I'm kidding. Let me finish the story. Okay, hang on. I'll talk about the PC in a second. You guys, shipping a PC is not too difficult if you travel with it and you have the right case. I'll explain. But everybody's at the desk getting the room. So I get up. They said they were going to call me. And then I get up and they said, oh, yeah, we can get your room. I'm like, what the fuck was I waiting for, man? Like, I was like literally decaying in the lobby on the couch. Like, I was losing my mind. I fell asleep like 4 times, like not trying to fall asleep. Like, I just leaned back and fell asleep. You know, that doesn't happen to me. I'm not narcoleptic. So I was dying. Finally get in the room at like 1:30, and I lay everything out. I didn't fully unpack like this, but I just started taking things out because I knew if I lied down and slept, nothing would happen. Nothing would get done. So I go back down to the lobby because I ordered this monitor and the microphone stands. The monitor that's on in this picture. The left monitor is a portable one that folds up. I got like a stand for it and shit. I also ordered the Astro headphones. They're really cheap. Don't tell anybody. And then the splitter, shit like that. Like stuff that I couldn't fit or didn't have. I go down to the lobby to open up the to get the packages, and I go to the desk and they're like, yeah, we can get it for you. They go back and the lady says, so they're locked up because they're purchased, and the guy who unlocks these packages leaves at 2:30. So I can email him and you can come get it tomorrow. I was like, wait, what the fuck? Why does he leave at 2:30 at a hotel? Like, but I was like, you know, delirious and like, you know, I'm a nice guy. I'm very polite. But the point is, I was just like, okay, all right. So I went back to the room and like tried to figure out like, should I Uber to a Best Buy? Should I cancel the order? Because like, what if we have to play today? I can't wait until tomorrow. So the schedule is they compete on Sunday. And I assume they have like pre-show stuff on Saturday, right? Like that's my guess, just because it's like an official event. So I flew in Thursday. I had Thursday and Friday. Today's Friday. I had 2 days. Every second is so important, you know? I was so stressed out, man. I texted my girlfriend and she's like, no, it's a hotel. Like that doesn't sound right. So I go back down and there's new people working at the desk. Like they shift changed or whatever. But then I went like, hey, I have these packages I really, really, really need. Is there any way you can get it? And they were like, yeah. And they just went and got it. So I was like, what the fuck? Fight. So if I unpack all this shit and this is, yeah, it was ridiculous. So this is the setup after I went and picked up the packages. The problem is everybody was so nice that I just believed them. Usually if somebody doesn't want to help you, like I'm used to them being like dickheads about it, you know, but they were like so nice about it. I thought, oh yeah, they, you know, there's nothing they can do. I was deceived. So I set up all this shit. You can see my PC over there. I had the webcam on there. The setup's a bit different now, but it's basically the same thing. And then what fucking happens is I get this all set up. I'm ready to speed test and test everything. And this is when I put out this tweet. Stay tuned, right? Here. Oh, I forgot about that. Good thing I tweeted, bro. I got like a little journal. So I was trying to plug in shit and it wouldn't work. There's like a network out port right here. It doesn't work. And I was like, okay. When I called the hotel before I even booked it, they said they had Ethernet in the rooms. So I try to grab the Ethernet that's plugged into the TV and plug that into my computer. And that doesn't work either. So I call the front desk and they say, yeah, we used to have Ethernet, but they took it out of every room. So the person who I called in the first place to book didn't have the right answer. 1 second. They took out all the Ethernet capability, so I can only do Wi-Fi. I pay for the expensive Wi-Fi, and I get what you see on the screen, like 9 up. I'm like, okay, this sucks, but it works, right? Like, at least I can stream. Whew. Lifting the chair took the fucking shit out of me, bro. So, let's see. I do this speed test. I'm chilling, and then I can't remember. When is this? When is this tweet sent? 4:16 p.m.? Okay. So Arslan had messaged me, but stopped messaging for a bit. So I was afraid he was like waiting for me, right? So I'm scrambling to get it together. And then, yeah. So what happens is this is at 9 p.m., but basically around 7, all of the fucking like networks just stop working, right? Everything stops working. I was like, yo, what the fuck? Not only do I not have Ethernet, I can't fucking use the Wi-Fi. So I'm at throughout this whole process, this is where hell starts. I start going back and forth between the lobby, the phone, and customer service. Engineers coming to my room to like troubleshoot from about 7 p.m. until literally, when did I, like 1 p.m. today? What was the time? Let me get my phone and check. My phone's in my damn pocket. Okay, hang on. My shit got fixed at 11:30. So I was on the phone. I've been struggling with this forever. Arslan knocks on my door. God, when did he knock on my door? Maybe like 7 p.m.? So this is right as the internet was going out and I was tweaking. Arslan's phone died. He didn't have the right charger. So he just went to his room and slept from like 1 till what? Let me see. I don't have a good recollection of the night, actually. Because I was so stressed the whole fucking time. Oh, no. Okay, this is way later. Okay. So the hotel internet goes out at like 7:30. I went to eat at 5:30. Okay, run it back. So before the whole internet goes out, I go to Best Buy to pick up a few extra things. I needed some more USB ports because I didn't plan very carefully. And then I needed like a HDMI DP thing for my other monitor. Small purchases, got some Panda Express, shit was lit, okay? And then I come back, the internet goes down. I'm like, what in the world, man? I was relaxed. I love like visiting California. It's so nice outside all the time. But that really put a fucking shit damper on my mood. Also, I couldn't get an Uber or a Lyft from the Panda. Like nothing was running. It took like 30 minutes to get like 5 minutes back. That shit was crazy. Anyways, Arslan knocks on my door at like 10:30. I was afraid I was keeping him waiting this whole time, right? But he was just asleep, so it was fine. We try to go to a convenience store. We just Google Maps it or whatever, and there's a place like really close. So we walk over. It's like a convenience store within a business building. So the business building is extremely closed because it's like 10:15. We couldn't even get inside. So I was like, what the fuck is this? Call an Uber to a 7-Eleven that's a bit down the road. Arslan needs to buy a new charger. He almost forgets the charger. Sorry, I'm dragging him. we were laughing about how he was forgetting a lot of stuff. So, but he liked the 7-Eleven. He was saying it was like, they don't have that in Pakistan. So, and then he also spoke Punjab with the guy behind the counter. So that was pretty cool. Like a little international moment. Next time text you. All right, I will, bro. My bad. No, we're not in Irvine. Punjabi. Yeah, the region is Punjab. They spoke Punjabi. My fault. Thank you. Anyways, we Uber back, and the Uber driver misses the turn twice and then goes against traffic in the parking lot, like into the exit. Get back to the room. I keep calling support. By this point, I'd been escalated to like a level 2 case, like the elevated support. Arslan is like chilling, eating. I'm trying to get this stuff solved. And then we watch his set with Atif Butt. I recorded all of our stuff because we couldn't stream it, but I recorded our interactions. I don't know how good the sound was and everything. Hello, Chanel. I recorded all of that. And then, oh, Arslan also asked me, like, what is it like drinking alcohol? Because I bought like a little wine box thing. And I tried to explain it, but I don't think I carried it across very well. Because keep in mind, I'm like insane right now. Right? So not only am I coming down from no sleep, horrible hangovers, and caffeine come down. I'm telling you guys, I was so insane. I was in the Best Buy. I was talking to myself. I was like, you know when you're in like a PS4 game? Like an over-the-shoulder PS4 game? Single player? And like you get lost because you're an idiot? So the character starts talking to you by talking to himself? Oh, the cable must not be here. Let's go check over there. You know what I mean? That was me. I was like that in the motherfucking Best Buy. I was like that in the room trying to set up my things. Like, oh, we need the... Oh, I didn't forget this box. It's right over there. Or I was like, no HDMI. I was literally talking to myself. I was going insane, okay? So Arslan's asking me, what's it like being an alcohol? I'm like, fuck if I know, man. Like, right now... Anyways, is the streamer effect kinda? I thought it was just an episode of Mania, low key. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, it was like a Nathan Drake moment. It was a 2000s PS3, PS4 single player video game.
Surveillance camera. So, let's see. What's the timeline? It's about 11 midnight. Arson said, let's just play. I'm like, okay, let's play. Guys, I play like dog shit. There's really no other way to put it. I think I lost 3-25 on his like 7 side characters. No, he played Julia and Katarina. Because he was trying to explore the Noctis matchup. And I'm not going to lie, he beat me. Like, he hit one, like the same string on me like 7 times in a row. I was not a human playing the game. So I'm excited to play him tonight because he probably was like, what the fuck am I doing here? What a waste of time. Like, like that's what it felt like. That's how bad I was playing. So, this whole time I'm also on hold with the phone, right? It got so bad, I was like down, like I won a game or something, and like he didn't start the next game because he was on Instagram. Like I was playing so bad that generic social media was more interesting than what was happening. But we had a really good time playing, and it was fun talking and hanging out with him. So it was funny in the moment because I'm like, not only can I not get the fucking internet fixed so I can stream me losing, I'm losing. What else is good? So we stay up till about 4, playing and me calling. Tony, thank you for the raid. We stay up until like 4 a.m. I'm still calling support. They keep saying like, oh, we'll call you when there's an update on the case. But just like the front desk, they never called me. So I kept calling back and kept hearing, oh, there's actually been an update. I'm not joking. I was on the phone from the extended period of like 10 p.m. to 4 a.m., okay? I have to get up for work at like 8:30. So I sleep a little bit, and then I wake up for work, all support again, first thing. Your case has not been updated. We've escalated it to the senior engineers. I'm like, okay, cool. If I don't get the internet by the end of today, none of this matters. Like, when the hotel staff came up and checked this shit out, the internet, they said they probably just need to reset the access point. So from that point last night, I was saying, can you please reset the access point? Can you please reset the access point? We can't have access to that. Which is probably true. They probably don't have access to it. But anyways, I'm stressing the fuck out trying to get some work done this morning. I'm about to, like, go into a spiral because, like, I spent so much money flying out here and doing all this stuff. The hotel is so expensive, bro. Like, I think I spent like $700 for the 3 nights, maybe 800. Like, it felt like a fucking major. So I'm stressed out because like I spent all this money and I'm like, am I not even going to get to like stream any of it? Like, do I have this like scuffed recording of like me losing to Arslan 3-25 and then like us watching a match that I can't even comprehend? Oh, Jesus. And then at 11:30, I'm like texting my girlfriend. I'm about to lose it. Like, it's over. I call support one more time, and they say, oh, it looks like your ticket's been updated. Can you run a speed test? That is when we get to the biggest relief of my life. God, I can't even describe how this felt. This felt like winning a fucking tournament. Yeah, this is when he beat the shit out of me. And then, 6 hours ago. So, like, at 11, I ran a speed test, and I got this, and I was like, oh my god, dude, thank you so much. Holy moly. So he scrambled to get this made. And now, Arslan told me he'd be here at like 4 or 5. So I try to get some more work done, and then I try to get some sleep. Because if I play the way I did, it's just not fun for anybody. It is 6 p.m. I'm definitely getting stood up. This stream is... This will be funny if it ends up working.
So that was a very long-winded but worthwhile story, I think, of how I got to meet Nii, Arslan Ash, Book... and level up my Tekken game, make some great content. You guys have seemed to really enjoy it, and I appreciate you showing all the support and love. It's been really great. As you can see, the last match here is a 1-2, my final set with Arslan that night, where I fought his Katarina, foreshadowing his grand final performance against CBM. Thanks for coming along the ride, you guys. Tekken 8 is going to be fantastic. I still got some more TWT... I still got some more TWT reviews to do, so stick around for those. Leave a like if you enjoyed this, leave a comment if you think I missed anything, or if you got any questions. If you got nothing, just leave an emoji. Helps a bunch. Enjoy the rest of the video. Peace.
I asked for that. KO. Round 2. Fight. Round 3. Fight.
Okay, just. Thank you for coming.
Yeah, that's a notable
time. 好きほうだやってんじゃねえぞ!